Hi, I'm Stephen Lam, and I work at Google on web performance. And today I want to tell you a little bit about browser caching and what you can do to configure your web pages so that they're cached properly in browsers. And you'll find that once you learn it, it's fairly easy to implement it, and you get a double win because not only do your web pages load more quickly, but then there's less of a load on your web servers as well. Browsers have caches to store local copies of resources in web pages because those resources often do not change for a long time. And by storing a local copy, the browser can avoid having to make another connection to the web server and downloading that resource again. So now I'd like to show you a demo where I'm going to show you a web page that has the resources with all the caching turned off so that each time this page is loaded, the browser has to request each image in this page. And then I'm going to show you the same page loaded again, but with the caching headers turned on. And you can see the difference in performance that it has on the web page. So here we're loading the page with the expires headers turned off for all the different resources. And as you can see, when the resources are coming in, they're all coming from the web server. Now I'm going to maximize the HTTP watch window so we can look at one image in particular and see what cache control headers it's set. If you look, the cache control header is set so that there is no cache, so that this item has to be requested from the server each time. The E tag is not set. And we have an expires header that is set in the past. Now moving on, we're going to load the same page, but this time all the images are going to have the expires header on. And so here I type in the different URL. I hit enter. And I'm going to maximize the HTTP window once again. I'm going to click on an image to show what the HTTP headers look like. So now when we look at the headers, we can see that the max age is set. It's set in seconds, and in this case it works out to 10 years in the future. There's still no e-tag set. There's also an expires header. Now if you set both max age and the expires header, the max age header will override the expires header. And finally, the last modified is set, and it's the same value before back in 2006. So now let's load the page with the expires on one more time. Click on the URL bar and hit enter. And we see that the page loads much more quickly this time because it's bringing everything from cache. And that's shown here with HTTP Watch by having everything in blue. As you can see, caching can have a big impact on the performance of your web pages. And it's one of the easier things to set up. So thank you for watching. And for more information, you can visit code.google.com/speed.